So today I want to get straight into it. I've been thinking a lot about Joseph. God has given me Joseph. Why? As many of you know, Joseph was given a promise. His promises were delivered to him via dreams. Joseph was prophetic. Joseph is one of my favorite stories in all of the Bible. Especially in the Old Testament, I should say. In the Old Testament, to specify. And the reason why is because Joseph had a lot. God gave him a lot. He gave him so much through dreams. And I find myself relating to Joseph in many ways. Because God has given me promises. He has given me prophetic visions. And it's difficult because when you share those things with certain particular people or individuals, family, friends, colleagues, associates, etc., so forth, many of them, in some instances, can be either happy for you. Some people can be just don't have anything to say. And some can even be, in majority cases, either jealous, envious, or negative. And that was the story with Joseph. When God gave Joseph these dreams, right? Joseph had a relationship with God. Not only did he have a relationship with God, he was favored by God. So when Joseph told his dreams to people around him, they were highly negative. Not only negative, they rebuked him. In addition to attempting to kill not only him, but most importantly, they tried to kill his dreams. How many of you, like Joseph, whose name means to add to increase, told your dreams to other people, and those people discouraged you? They provided negative insight and feedback. They attempted to kill your dream. Interesting enough, what they attempted to do by killing your dream was attempted to kill the plans of God. Know this one thing. It's not about you, but it's about the hatred of God. That's where negativity comes from. That's where it stems from. It's nothing personal against you. The devil, he doesn't want God's plan to come to fruition. Because this wasn't something that Joseph was making up. It wasn't Joseph's imagination. This was the plan of God. And so for your dreams and for the promises that God made to you, it's not about those people who are saying negative things, colleagues, coworkers, family, friends, whatever the case is, or them not showing support. It's about the enemy working through them to destroy the plans of God. There was a particular reason why Joseph was given those particular dreams, why he was chosen, why he was exalted above the rest. Because God could use him. And that's the same thing, the same type of intention that God has for you. His purpose and his plan is to use you. Why? Because he has found favor with you. It's because you serve. So those who serve like Joseph, because he was a shepherd boy. Not only was he a shepherd boy, but he took care of his father's wives. That servant was exalted. So if you want to find your promises quickly coming to fruition, and through the process of long suffering, right, which means waiting, which is something that we hate to do because we live in an instantaneous generation. Serve. God is looking for people who have the heart of gold to serve. He's not going to give his promises of exaltation, of privilege, to those who would take and use it for their own selfish gain. No. That's why he gave you the promise, because he feels as though you, out of all people, have the character and the audacity, the faith and the spirituality to make his will come to pass. It's all about his will. It's all about the advancement of God's purpose. For his purpose is good, and it is upright, and it is selfless for all people. So understand that that promise will come to pass. Like Joseph, people around him attempted to kill his promise and his dreams, what God intended for his life. But how many of you all know that the promises of God are yea and amen? So know this, no matter what people do to you, no matter what people say, how they are negative, how they choose and refuse to support you through your dreams of what God gave to you, know this, that the devil will use them, but God will exalt you above the situation. Yes, you may face difficulties, you may face criticism, you may face setbacks and destructive schisms against you. But know that God ultimately will prevail. His will prevail, irregardless of what they do to you. The attempt of the enemy is to have you to doubt, to have you to question, to have you to give up and to believe the negativity that surrounds what God purposed you to do. But ultimately, God will ultimately make your enemies your footstool, and they will come to you like they came to Joseph, bowing before you. And in return, you will have compassion. In return, you will know that it was never about you, but it was about the will and the advancement of the kingdom of God. Some people are not given the favor and the promises. Why? Because they don't have the relationship. Why? Because they don't believe. Why? Because they've been given, they have all their ulterior motives that is rooted in selfishness and self-exaltation. So continue to develop your character while going through long suffering. Continue to serve. Continue to exalt and glorify God. Continue to believe every single word of his promises. For they will and shall come to pass. God bless you. I'll see you next time.